Your Excellency, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Argentina and Vice President of the Conference, Heads of States and Government, Your Excellency Fernanda Espinosa, President of the 73rd Session of the General Assembly, Your Excellency Inga Londa King, the President of the Economic and Social Council, Mr. Achim Steiner, UNDP Administrator, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great honor for me to speak today at the celebration of the 40th anniversary of the landmark International Conference on South-South Cooperation that led to the Buenos Aires Plan of Action, known as BAPA. I would like to express at the outset my appreciation for the government and the people of Argentina under the leadership of President Macri for their warm reception in hosting us here. I would like to thank the Secretary General, Mr. Antonio Guterres, for his support in convening this conference, and Her Excellency Maria Fernanda Espinosa, the President of the General Assembly, for leading the intergovernmental process. I would also like to thank my fellow co-facilitator of the outcome document for this conference, Her Excellency Ambassador Udra Prepriat, permanent representative of Lithuania to the United Nations, for her hard work bringing all parties together in open, transparent, and inclusive consultations to achieve consensus on this historic piece of legislation. I take this opportunity on behalf of myself and Ambassador Udra to express our sincere appreciation to all delegates for their support and constructive engagement in the process. In this regard, our work would not have been possible without the steadfast support of the United Nations Office for South-South Cooperation in facilitating our negotiations. We thank you. Excellencies, the 1978 Buenos Aires Plan of Action was an important step taken by developing countries to enhance cooperation among countries of the South and provide the platform for international community to support these development efforts. This is an occasion to recognize and underscore 40 years of collaborative initiatives among developing countries that have helped to improve the lives of millions across the Global South. Solidarity among peoples and countries of the Global South has contributed to the improvement of developing countries' national well-being and collective self-reliance. Together with what BAPA stressed as an important partnership with developed countries and multilateral agencies, now known as triangular cooperation, South-South cooperation has enhanced developing countries' capacity to attain national priorities and other international agreed development goals, especially the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, balancing economic, social, and environmental dimensions. The South's strong economic performance in the recent past has enabled southern countries to achieve important milestones in the reduction of poverty and extreme hunger, improved education and health, and other positive gains. We welcome the emergence of new southern financing sources, including regional development banks and other national development banks. The tremendous achievements of the South importantly include initiatives by developing and least developed countries, which have themselves developed innovative successes in critical areas such as food security, access to information, and communication technologies, among others. Despite rapid progress of southern cooperation in scale, scope, dimension, challenges remain as southern countries, particularly LDCs, continue to face enormous development challenges in terms of high prevalence of poverty, malnutrition and unemployment, serious deficits in infrastructure and productive capacities, and the impact of external shocks. Excellencies, this conference is important in revitalizing our efforts to address these challenges through strong, broad-based partnerships based on international solidarity. We must seize this opportunity to exploit the full potential of South-South cooperation as complement to, not a substitute, to North-South cooperation. We have clearly laid out our expectations for the United Nations funds, programs, and specialized agencies to help achieve our goals, to help us share concrete solutions to support South-South cooperation by acting as catalysts for cooperation and strengthen the capacities of regional organizations. I note with appreciation that many United Nations entities have integrated South-South and Triangular Cooperation into their respective strategic frameworks or work plans and designed innovative South-South and Triangular Cooperation initiatives to benefit developing countries. I urge you, the United Nations, to intensify its support in facilitating access to knowledge and expertise of developing countries as a basis for applying South-South cooperation in the implementation of the 2030 Agenda. I encourage member states to continue engaging in policy dialogue within the High-Level Committee on South-South Cooperation and further enhance South-South and Triangular Cooperation through sharing their homegrown successes with each other. Excellencies, we must employ our collective strengths in identifying and tackling challenges specific to developing country circumstances. I am confident that this conference will result in the political impetus for us to start charting a strategic course together to ensure that the benefits of South-South and Triangular Cooperation impact the lives of people around the world. I thank you.